They were inseparable. French Bulldog Lola and her owner, 33-year-old Christian Morales from Spain. When Lola died, he had a sample of her DNA frozen so that one day he could bring her back to life.
I want to clone my dog Lola because I feel like our story isn't really over. We had an accident a year ago. Lola broke her back and needed surgery. Then she got blood poisoning and ended up dying of pneumonia.
Lola lived to the age of 9. Everything in Christian's apartment in Barcelona reminds him of his dog. She was like family to him.
That's her food bowl, her water bowl. She absolutely loved tennis balls. She would fetch every single one.
What's left are memories and Lola's ashes. Just after she died, Christian had her tissue sampled in order to one day create a clone.
It would be like seeing Lola again, like she were here again physically. I know it wouldn't actually be Lola, but it's the same genes. It'd be like a daughter of Lola that she never actually had, or a twin sister born in another time.
In Marbella, in southern Spain, this lab at first had specialized in cloning top-dollar thoroughbreds. Now it's the first in Europe to add dogs and cats to its portfolio.
They are almost identical copies. If the dog was curious, its clone will be too. If the original was shy, the clone will be too. Of course, it's a different animal, but genetically it's practically the same. So it'll behave in nearly the same ways.
This Rottweiler is also meant to be cloned and is getting her tissue sampled for 2,800 euros. The cloning procedure itself costs another 55,000 euros.
Many clients hire us to clone their pets that are on the verge of dying or have just died. And that helps them overcome their grief tremendously. If a client can afford to make a copy of their pet, they will.
But does cloning a pet truly help owners grieve less? Psychologists like Andres Martin don't think so.
You can't get around mourning or prolong your relationship with a pet. A clone is always just a biological copy, but you can't clone its consciousness and life story. So the pain and feeling of loss will remain the same.
But the demand for pet cloning remains high. Samples from hundreds of pets are being stored here. So far, 11 have been used to make a copy.
The client calls, and we introduce ourselves, provide information, and explain what a clone actually is. We explain that it's not a replacement of the original pet, so we're not deceiving clients.
Christian has only paid to sample and store Lola's tissue. He's still unsure about actually cloning her.
I think it's a lucrative business and far too expensive. But maybe the price will drop over time. Then I'll reconsider. I've kept that option open for myself by preserving Lola's genes in the first place.
That way he could have more than just memories. And in the future,
I always imagine having Lola again when I'm old and retired. That way, I could bring things full circle and get to have my dog from my younger days back again.
Christian is spending 500 euros a year just to conserve Lola's genes. For him, getting Lola back is worth the price.